If you look up into the sky on a sunny day after a rainfall, you will notice that you are able to see a structure like this. Do you know what this structure is? This is known as a rainbow. Generally, you are able to see a rainbow when the sun shines after it has rained. Now, we have studied that the sun gives us white light. Yet, in the rainbow, you can see multicolors. That is, you can see red, you can see violet, green, and many other colors. So, if the sun is giving us only white light, where are these colors coming from? You will be interested to learn that nature is able to break this white light into its respective constituents. That is, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. That is Vibgyor. Now, if nature can split white light into its 7 constituents, can we humans do so? We find that nature can disperse white light into its 7 colors. Now, can we disperse this white light? Let us take a look at an interesting video to see how it can be done. In this video, an instrument has been used that is known as a prism. Now, with the help of this instrument, that is a prism, we are able to break white light into its 7 colors. As you can see, this prism is kept in the face of sunlight, and the different colors that are present in white light are obtained on the wall placed opposite to the prism. If you observe this animation, this is how a prism works. As you can see, refraction takes place and white light is broken into 7 colors. So we can say that just like we can see a rainbow and the 7 colors in a rainbow, we have also managed to break down white light into its 7 constituent colors. So the instrument that was used is known as a prism. A prism is basically a closed surface that has 2 opposite sided triangles, and the refracting surfaces are parallelograms. But we, in our dealings with prisms, consider a special case of prism, that is, a triangular prism. Now, in a triangular prism, these opposite sides are equal triangles and they are parallel to one another. Also, the sides of the triangular prism, that is, these sides are rectangles in the case of a triangular prism. So, in our discussions, we shall be dealing with triangular prisms only. Now, this is a schematic for a triangular prism. You will notice that the prism has 2 refracting surfaces, that is, the surfaces where the refraction of light takes place. These surfaces are A, B, E, and D, which is this surface, and another surface is A, C, F, and D, that is this surface. So these 2 surfaces of the prism that are shaded in blue are known as the refracting surfaces of the prism. And if you look closely, the angle BAC, that is the angle in between the 2 refracting surfaces, is known as the angle of prism. That is, angle BAC is known as the angle of prism, also denoted by A. So, in our ray diagrams, when we discuss about prisms, we shall be representing this structure as a triangle. Why? Because as you can see, if we look at a prism from the front, we can see a triangle. And this surface is a refracting surface, so it is considered to be this surface. And this surface is also another refracting surface. So this surface for the triangle is considered to be the second refracting surface. So, in our dealings, this structure is represented by a triangle. Now, let us look at how dispersion or breaking down of white light into its seven constituents is taking place in the glass prism. As you can see, white light is incident from air to glass. That is from a rarer medium to a denser medium. So in this case, refraction occurs and white light bends towards the normal at the point of incidence. Now you will be interested to learn that the seven different constituents of white light travel with different speeds inside a medium, that is any medium apart from air. So in glass, these seven constituents have different speeds. So when they have different speeds, they will bend to different amounts. So when they are bending by different amounts, what do you think will happen? They will come apart from one another. Or in other words, they will separate and will be broken down. So as a result, due to this separation, we are able to see these seven colors once white light is getting refracted. Now these seven constituents or seven colors are incident on the second surface of the prism. Again, at this surface, which is the glass-air interface, refraction takes place. Now over here, the light is incident from a denser medium to a rarer medium. Now they will bend away from the normal. So once they bend away from the normal, they travel in the direction as you can see. So since the two surfaces of the prism are not parallel to one another, we are able to obtain a non-parallel beam of light. That is, the emergent beam is not parallel to the incident beam. And thus, we are able to obtain the seven different constituents of white light. That is, from violet to red, as you can see. Now, you will be wondering that since we are using a glass prism and a glass is transparent, why are we not using a parallel-sided glass slab? As you can see in this picture, a parallel-sided glass slab has been shown and a single beam is considered. So when this beam is hitting the air-glass interface, refraction is taking place and it is bending towards the normal. After traveling in glass, it hits the glass-air interface and refraction takes place again and we have the emergent ray. Now, if you observe closely and if you recall from our previous discussion, the incident beam is always parallel to the emergent beam in the case of a glass slab and a parallel-sided glass slab in this case. So, what do you think will happen? Let us find out. If white light is incident on a parallel-sided glass slab, we will notice that there is no dispersion taking place. One thing is true, that when white light is hitting the air-glass interface on the first surface, dispersion or breaking down of white light will take place. But when this white light is incident on the glass-air interface, they will recombine again and form a beam that is so close to one another that this light will appear to us as white light. That is, when these beams are refracted at the second surface, they are emerging in a direction that is parallel to the incident beam. As a result, what is happening is the light that had previously dispersed or broken down inside glass are getting recombined once they are leaving the glass medium. Now, because they are recombining and are appearing very close to one another, our eyes are unable to distinguish the colors and it appears white to us. So this is the reason why we cannot use a parallel-sided glass slab, because we are not able to observe the breaking down of white light into its constituent colors. Now you must be wondering that if we can't use a parallel-sided glass slab, why can we not use a convex lens or a concave lens? Now, if you recall from our previous discussions, we had approximated that the center portion of a convex lens can be depicted by a parallel-sided glass slab. Similar was the case for concave lens. Even the central portion of a concave lens can be depicted by a parallel-sided glass slab. So we just learned that we are unable to break down white light into its 7 constituents in a parallel-sided glass slab. So as a result, since the central portion of the convex lens and a concave lens can be approximated as a parallel-sided glass slab, no dispersion occurs in this case. So we are using a prism for the dispersion of white light. The breaking down of white light into its 7 constituent colors that are known as the spectrum is known as dispersion of white light. After dispersion of white light, we are getting violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, and red. This is known as the spectrum of white light. And there is an easy way to remember the colors that are present in white light. What is the easy way? If you take the first letters of each word, you will see that the word you get is Vibgior, where V stands for violet, I for indigo, B for blue, G for green, Y for yellow, O for orange, and R for red. So Vibgior represents the spectrum of white light. So how can we technically define dispersion and spectrum? Dispersion of white light is the phenomenon of splitting white light by a prism into its constituent colors. So as the prism was splitting white light or breaking down white light into its 7 constituent colors, that phenomenon is termed as dispersion. And what is spectrum? The color band obtained on a screen on passing white light through a prism is known as the spectrum. If you recall from the video, we had obtained the 7 different colors of white light on a paper or even on the wall in front of the prism. So the colors that were obtained, the band of colors, the 7 constituent colors of white light, that color band is known as the spectrum of white light. And it was obtained after white light passed through a prism. So going back to our previous question, where we saw that nature was able to break down white light and form what we called rainbows. Now, how do you think rainbows are being formed? We just learned that to obtain the 7 different colors, we need a prism. Where is nature getting its prism? Let us see. Now, you must remember 2 things for rainbows. Rainbows are formed when the sun is shining and raining at the same time. And secondly, the sun should be on the opposite side of the rainbow. Now, you will be interested to learn that when it is raining, there are droplets, millions and millions of droplets in the air. These tiny droplets of water are acting as glass prisms for nature. So as you can see, raindrops act as tiny glass prisms. And it is due to this fact that raindrops can split white light into its 7 constituent colors. So we learn that the tiny droplets of water are acting as prisms for nature, and that is why we are able to see the rainbow. Let us find out through ray diagrams how it is happening. So in this case, we consider one raindrop. You can see that sunlight is incident on this raindrop. So on going from air to water, that is the raindrop, it encounters a change in medium, as a result of which refraction takes place and the light bends towards the normal. Now since the 7 different constituent colors travel with 7 different speeds inside a dense medium, the white light is broken down into its constituent colors, that is from violet to red. So after refraction at this surface, it travels on. Now the moment it encounters this surface, that is the droplet air interface, it undergoes reflection. Why? Because the angle, this angle and this angle at which the constituent colors are incident exceeds the critical angle for water air media. That is, the respective angles of incidence are greater than the critical angle for these two pair of media. So as a result, total internal reflection is taking place and no refraction. So as a result, these rays get reflected. Now again, they encounter a change in media. So let us find out what happens. At this media, no reflection takes place because the angle of incidence is lesser than critical angle. We have already studied that in this case, the angles are greater than critical angle. So as a result, total internal reflection was taking place. But here, such is not the case. So since no reflection is taking place, the rays are refracted and they move out from the raindrop in a way that you can see. So our eyes perceive these rays coming out and we are finally able to see the rainbow being formed. This happens in the case of millions of other raindrops and we are able to see the beautiful structure that we call a rainbow. So let us take a quick recap. What did we learn so far? We learned that just like nature, even we can break down white light into its 7 constituent colors. The 7 constituent colors have different speeds in a dense medium. So this is the reason why we were able to obtain 7 different constituent colors after refraction. We used a prism for this purpose. We saw that the breaking down of 7 constituent colors of white light is known as the dispersion of white light. And the band of the 7 different colors that we obtained was known as the spectrum of white light. We also saw how nature is able to form a rainbow or how nature is able to break down white light into its 7 different colors. Tiny droplets, when it rains, act as prisms. And these prisms are able to break down light into its 7 colors, and thus we are able to see a rainbow.